One of the things Elmer's says, has been saying in the hospital, I don't know anything. I don't know anything. Well, Bonnie has convinced her that it's all right, because Bonnie knows everything. And I want you to know, I found out you can honestly say that. With age comes wisdom, right?
That's exactly right.
There is a jar of honey in the kitchen that says Bonnie B.C.
B.C.
All right.
Not quite that old.
Our scripture reading today comes from James chapter 3, verses 13 through 18. If you are wise and understand God's ways, prove it by living an honorable life, doing good works with the humility that comes from wisdom. But if you are bitterly jealous and there is selfish ambition in your heart, don't cover up the truth with boasting and lying. For jealousy and selfishness are not God's kind of blessing. Such things are earthly, unspiritual, and demonic. For wherever there is jealousy and selfish ambition, there you will find disorder and evil of every kind. But the wisdom from above is first of all pure. It is also peace-loving, gentle at all times, and willing to yield to others. It is full of mercy and good deeds. It shows no favoritism and is always sincere. And those who are peacemakers will plant seeds of peace and reap a harvest of righteousness.
Like no other can do.
between the Sunday school lesson and the music this morning. I think they've covered just about what James is trying to make a point of in this scripture. I've been saying, because I read it somewhere, that James is sort of like Proverbs of the New Testament. Well, this week, I took the impression that it's not like the book of Proverbs. It is, James is addressing a situation in the early churches. He found it that it wasn't to his liking. So he was addressing the problem before it got worse. And what he's talking about in this, he could be saying to the churches today. He's saying to people, you know, remember, he's writing to the 12 tribes that are scattered out of Jerusalem. They're still Jews, so he's not teaching them Jewish law. He's not teaching them Jewish customs. He's talking about how Christ had told them to change the way they're living to what God meant, not what the scribes and the Pharisees and the rabbis had taught them. And that's what he's saying here. He's saying, be wise. Watch your tongue. Don't cause more problems. Not all of you ought to be leaders. That's what he meant by teachers. And he's carrying that on here. He said, be wise and get your wisdom from God, not from those around you. And he contrasts the wisdom. Earthly wisdom is not from above. It's earthly. It makes no attempt at looking to God. It's sensual. It feels good. If it feels good, I'll do it. It feels right. That's what I think I ought to do. That's earthly wisdom. It's demonic. It's Satan. It's the very reason Satan exists. Satan is trying to convince God. I'm of the opinion that one book I read, that the reason Satan exists is because he's arguing with God about the creation of humans. Satan is saying, you got angels, what do you need them things for? You got me, what do you need the rest of the angels for? That's Satan's attitude. And what he's doing is trying to separate us from God. And he makes it look so good. He makes it look so appealing. And he tries to make us jealous for some of that. He tries to make us want that when God says, that's not for you. Godly wisdom is from above. It comes from God. How do we get it? We get it by prayer. It's through prayer. And not taking our Christmas wish list. It's by listening. Going into a state of prayer and listening. How do we know the natures of these two wisdoms? Earthly wisdom. See how many people that you know who have positions of authority that have this. Full of bitter envy. I want what they got. They get too much attention doing that. It's self-seeking. I want to be as popular. I want to be considered as important. I want to be the big I. I want to get that recognition. It's for things like power, position, privilege, and prestige. That's what people want. That is earthly wisdom. But heavenly wisdom. First of all, heavenly wisdom is pure. There's no uncleanliness in it. It's from God. It is true to God's will. It's peaceable. It's never stirring up an unholy strife. What's in our churches? What is pushing so many young people out of our churches? It's the political gamesmanship that people in churches play. I haven't There's a new article out this week from the guy that's taken over Barna Research. You've all heard of Barna. It's a research organization, opinion gathering organization, and deals primarily with churches. And the young adults are not turning away from God. They're turning away from the structure of the organized church. And the reason they're doing that is because of the people, the power that's in the churches, and the way they're doing it. Are we looking to Christ? Are we spiritual? Do we try to be peaceable? Do we try to be gentle? Do we want things done our way, or am I willing to let you do it your way? I can't get over the phrase that John Ed Matheson from Fraser Memorial in Montgomery, Alabama. He was speaking to the Western Carolina Pastors Association. And he made the comment and said, "Preachers, if you know everything that's going on in your church, there ain't enough going on in your church. We got pastors who like to manipulate and control everything that's going on in their church. They've got to have that authority. They've got to have..." That's not Christ-like. And that's not people-like. That's not heavenly wisdom. There are people who may want to do it a different way. They might get to the same place you want to do it. What makes your way right? What makes their way wrong just because they thought of it? There are people that have that attitude. Heavenly wisdom is willing to yield. Are you willing to let somebody try it that way? You know where wisdom is. You know there's a difference between wisdom and knowledge. Knowledge you get from other people. You go to school. You take courses. You study. You read books. You get knowledge. Wisdom comes from effective use of that knowledge. If I touch the stove is hot. And I touch it. It's going to hurt. If I'm lucky, it's going to hurt. Well, wisdom comes when I don't touch it again. See, I know it's hot. I know it hurts when I touch it. Wisdom says, better not do that. See, wisdom comes from experience. And how can people gain wisdom if they get no experience? And the people in control don't like to see that. Heavenly wisdom is full of mercy. Ever ready to show pity and compassion and extend forgiveness to a repentant offender. We know that James says, faith without works is dead. We have to let that faith work. And it's without partiality. Now, normally we think of that is if we have two visitors come in. One dressed like Chris and one dressed like Doc. If they had sat on different sides, how would we have treated them? They're the same. I'd say that because Chris has got his t-shirt, probably his blue jeans on, which is...
He can't hear you anyway.
Okay. But that's normally the way we think of partiality. But it can also mean positions here, not a visitor. We're talking about the power structure here. How do we treat somebody that's in power and somebody that's not? Do we brown nose or do we do our thing? That's what that means. And it's without hypocrisy. I'm going to let you do it. Did you see what she wants to do? Have you heard how she wants it? That's hypocrisy. That's not heavenly wisdom. That's going back to that runaway tongue. Look at the fruits. Earthly wisdom. You get confusion. You get resentment. You get anger. You get the attitude that that's going to do everything. I'm just not going to try anymore. That's earthly wisdom. Heavenly wisdom. You got peace. You got willing to take part. Everything the fruit of righteousness instead of problems. So So we look to God for wisdom. We don't look to what the world tells us we ought to do. We look to God. And we look at the nature of the wisdom, and we look at the result of it. How do we get it? Earthly wisdom? Hey, you don't have to worry about it. It comes. It just rubs off on us. If everybody's cheating on their taxes, well, I can do that same thing. I can claim that as a deduction. I don't have to keep good count of it. No, that type of thing. But if it's heavenly, we have to look to God. Not only look, not only listen, not only read, not only gain the knowledge. It is a matter of walking what we say we believe. I believe this, yeah. The Bible says that. I believe it. But I see you doing this. I may not tell you this, but if I'm out there in the world, but I see you doing this and going there, and I don't see anything, I don't see how it's affected your life. You're living just like I do. Except you're wasting your Sunday mornings in church. That's what the world sees. That's earthly wisdom. Jesus asked his apostles. He says, who does the world say I am? They tell him, but who do you say that I am? Peter said, you are the Messiah, the Son of the living God. Later, Peter is preaching. And they say to him, what must we do to be saved? He said, each of you must repent of your sins, turn to God, be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ to show that you have received forgiveness of your sins. Then you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is for all who accept. We aren't made smarter, richer, or anything. We're just assured of salvation with God. The question is, are we demonstrating heavenly wisdom in our walk? Think about that. Amen. Sing one verse of number 130. God will take care of you.